Hello everyone, welcome back to part 22 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, I'm going to show you how to package your Endless Runner game for Windows. Let's get started. First, we need to install some required software. You can find a document with all the requirements and their download links in the description. You need to install Visual Studio 2022 and the latest Windows SDK. You can find both links in the document. While installing Visual Studio, also download these components: .NET Desktop Development, Desktop Development with C++, and Game Development with C++. You can download and install the Windows SDK from the Visual Studio installer itself, or you can download it separately from the Microsoft website. Once all the requirements are installed, open your Unreal Engine project, click on Platforms, and then click on Refresh Platform Status. Wait a few seconds while it refreshes. Once it's done, you will see the Windows logo and the SDK version that is installed. Now, go to the Project Settings, then navigate to Maps and Modes. For the game default map, make sure it is set to your game's main menu map. This is the map that will load first every time you open the package game. Now, to adjust the packaging settings, in Project Settings, select Packaging under Project. Expand Advanced and find the list of maps to include in a packaged build. Click the Add button and include the maps you want in the game. This is helpful if you have many maps that are unnecessary. Also, under Directories to Never Cook, you can select the folders that you don't want the engine to cook. Under Project, set the build configuration to Shipping. Choose the staging directory path where you want the packaged files to be saved. I recommend not enabling full rebuild for every package, but only when making significant changes to the game. Enable for distribution if you plan to release the game on stores like Steam or itch.io. If you are going to publish the game on stores like Steam, you can disable Include Prerequisites Installer, but if you are planning to publish it on sites like itch.io, I highly recommend you enable Include Prerequisites Installer. Scroll down to find the Platforms section and click on Windows. For the default RHI, I recommend enabling DirectX 11 if you want to support older gen computers and if you are not using Lumen, Nainite, or other DirectX 12 features. Enable DirectX 12 if you want to use Lumen or Nainite. If you scroll down, you can see the game splash screen and icon. You can change them to your own. You can check the dimensions required for the icon and splash by hovering over the images. To package the game, go back to the viewport, click on Platforms, then Windows, and click on Package Project. Select the directory to package. The first time you package the project, it may take a while, so be patient. You can see that for me, it took 11 minutes to stage and package the game. And the final package size is about 350 megabytes. That's it for today's video. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have any errors or need assistance, feel free to contact me via Discord. The details are in the description. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.